viewer.
Hello, viewer.
Super GT here. Hi. And a certain Mr. Jimmy Broadbent doesn't need any introduction. I don't think so. We have been reunited. Cheeky little dab. Yeah, so we've got an hour-long race, actually. I think it's going to be a real test. I think by the end of it, because most of us haven't raced in so long, it's going to be a bit of a killer. We'll send ourselves to the Shadow Realm. Shadow Realm represent. Do the sponsors proud and all that good malarkey. Right, let's get into qualifying.
Jimmy actually picking up a penalty there before the race even starts. Not very good news. Okay, here I am. Shadow Realm Racing. You can see the new suit. Lovely stuff. It's a shame we haven't been able to race together this year properly. Myself and Jimmy, we had good plans for the Endurance Series in 2020 before someone ate a bat. But there you go. Things happen, don't they? Okay, so I'm at Clay Pigeon. This race actually was from end of July. I've just been really slow getting my videos out, but you should be able to enjoy it nonetheless. My engine took a while to start here, actually. But yeah, you wouldn't think it's July, the middle of summer, because of the shoddy weather. But this is just typical in the United Kingdom. We're at Clay Pigeon in Dorset, southern England. And as we leave the pit lane here, well, what do you know? Lewis Hamilton, number 44, has already binned it about 2 metres out of the pit lane. Not very blessed, is it? Not very blessed at all. We've got another car off on the right-hand side there. And coming into the first corner, Billy's blind. Actually, another car off on the left-hand side. So lots of carts off. You can see the track is, at this point here, mostly dry, but still with some wet patches dotted about here and there. So tricky conditions to try to warm up in. And this session is just a practice which morphs into qualifying. So it's really just a case of getting the car warmed up, seeing if it's any good, and just acclimatizing to the circuit and seeing how we do. So this, as I said, is a race from end of July. You're going to have to excuse the camera and sound because it's on my Insta360 camera, which isn't as good as the GoPro that I now have, so you're gonna have to excuse all of that. But you should still be able to enjoy the video, hopefully. Okay, it wasn't too long before I actually managed to find Mr. Jimmy Broadbent. There he is with his ever noticeable helmet design that you can see from many, many miles away. Very, very unique. And I thought I'd initiate him into Shadow Realm Racing by going for the biggest dive bomb of all time into the final corner, which isn't really, well, it is an overtaking opportunity, but you don't often dive bomb it too much. At least I don't. So he's well and truly now part of the team. Shadow Realm Racing, we're both out on track together, actually. It's actually quite an interesting and very strange feeling to be racing on track with Jimmy. Obviously, we know each other from YouTube, from sim racing, but then to actually race together on track in real life is actually quite a peculiar feeling. Coming into the pit lane, I thought I'd get my kart tested. You can do that just to see if it's actually on the pace. The karts are, you know, the whole idea is that they are the same, but they're not exactly the same. So we let Nicky Richardson go out onto the track, give the kart a go, and see how he fares. So left the camera running and we can see how he does. So this is something that you normally always do, if you've got the time, just give it a run out with a test driver, and they have a transponder on and they can see how quick they can go, and you know, if the car is off the pace, they'll let you know about it. So we'll let him have a go. We can also go flying through this final corner. And actually, you can pick up quite a few tips from the way he drives, and just in general the smoothness and how early on the power he is. That's going to be the main thing in these karts. So a lot of people ask me for tips in these karts, and the main thing I would say is smoothness and how quickly you get on the power. Those tend to be the two main things I would say. But it wasn't too long before he came in. And the cart was satisfactory. You can see the thumbs up there. So I had no excuses, apparently. and I jumped back in to go back out for my qualifying lap, which was, qualifying was about to stop, so coming out the pit lane, hold your hand up just so you can, people see that you're a slow moving vehicle coming out of the pit lane, and don't want to ruin anyone else's lap, so putting him through, go up the inside, and now we can settle into the pack here. So here's my qualifying lap, let's have a look. Over the line, you've got this fast kink to the left, flat out, on the brakes. It's a very fast right-hander here, and you should be flat out through the chicane. So you can see keeping the right foot planted down, coming over towards the hairpin, over a slight bump, and then you apex quite early on this corner, power out to the outside, and then the horseshoe, difficult corner this, quite a technical one, apex early, and you don't really always have to apex at the second part. And then a flat out right kink, and then into the final corner, make or break. This can make or break your lap, as you have to be committed a little bit wider than the exit. But then we come down towards the start finish line. So quite a short lap here at Clay Pigeon. But that was the end of qualifying, and I don't know if I was too pleased with my lap, to be honest. It was all right, but I maybe could have done a little bit better.
Qualified in ninth. Jimmy's 11th, and I'm about half a second off the lead. So, not the best session, but I'll turn up in the race. That's normally my plan. Let's go.
Okay, time for the race. Qualifying wasn't all that great. I qualified 9th, about 4.5 tenths away from pole position. But this is going back to July, and this was the first race I had done in quite a while. So that's my excuse anyway, my racing driver excuse. So we've got Jimmy there on the left-hand side. He was actually in 11th, so because of the way that we start on the rows, he was actually directly behind me on the grid. So he performed well, and he's well up there in the mid towards front pack. So here we go then, an hour-long race. Turns out to be 88 laps. P9 on the grid. I'm actually on the other side, I think. I'm on the wrong side. But as we start the race, there's a big space on my right-hand side, as you can see there, so I'm going to slot into the right-hand side, which is actually the inside, and we're immediately into 7th. So that's actually a decent start, moving up a couple of positions, and the race is already settled down into single file. Now, take a look at the carts ahead. One guy goes up the inside, goes through a puddle that unsettles him. He's got no grip on the slick tyres, and he spins around and collects someone else, sending the pair of them to the Shadow Realm, and immediately you can see I've already got quite a big gap back to 6th place. So I've settled into 5th, and the one thing I was worried about was slipstream, as already I'm out of the range of slipstream with parts ahead, and that is actually really important around this track because you've got a lot of straight lines and you can gain many tenths per lap just by being in the slipstream, and I'll have to certainly try and push and try to get back onto the tail of the cars ahead as quickly as possible. Coming into the hairpin once again, and we have another incident. Another car gets pushed wide. That's Jack O'Neill getting absolutely shafted at the hairpin. So we've gained 3 positions in 2 laps purely from people getting wiped out at that hairpin. And we're up into 4th place already from 9th. And Jimmy actually had an incident. He actually managed to bin it at the chicane on the first lap, which is unfortunate. You know, obviously you don't want to bin it, and binning it on the first lap is the worst time because obviously everyone is going to go faster. And so that was frustrating for him. See the gaps here? First place is in sight, and then you've got second and third just in front as well. But I was dropping off, I would admit. I just didn't quite have the pace I felt in the car, but also in myself. Bit of both really. Clay Pigeon has never been one of the stronger tracks. You can see I'm pushing, going for a bit of human DRS down the straights, which you kind of need to do. As I said, there's so much drag here, and I am quite tall, so you do need to tuck down behind that wheel if possible. Give yourself every chance, but we are dropping back, which is frustrating. I'm trying to be as consistent as possible, that's all I can do. It is a long race, it's an hour long race. So every lap matters, all the consistency you can get. You know, if you're losing a tenth every lap over 88 laps, you know, 8.8 seconds that would be at the end, which is a big difference. Lap 24 now, and Jack O'Neill, who's the guy who got wiped out here on lap 2, coming back through, and there's no point fighting it. It's an hour-long race, so I felt like I might as well just tuck in. Through here, I just felt like I didn't have the pace coming out of that corner. You see, it already dropped me by a couple of car lengths. And all I can do really is just try to tuck in the best I can, try to follow him. And, you know, he is probably going to drive off to the distance. He does seem a lot quicker. He did qualify a lot further ahead on than me on the grid. But we'll do our best to try to stay somewhat within the draft. Fair old long way to go in the race, though. Going to be a difficult ask. Through the hairpin, actually, I think I probably took that better than he did there. Actually gained a slight amount. So that gives me some vague hope of perhaps being able to rescue some speed. But it's just through here. You see on the exit, just losing a car length or two. And over 88 laps, you know, you're going to lose a car length every time coming out of there. Then it's going to be difficult. So perhaps need to be on the power a little bit earlier. Coming across the line to start lap 27, Jack O'Neill again, you can see here, just pushing away. And we get overtaken. So we've been demoted into sixth. So we had a good start in this race, going from ninth to fourth. But then now, the underwhelming pace is beginning to pay true. And an uncharacteristic mistake there, a little bit frustrating, just overcooked on the brakes, going into the hairpin. And we've dropped off by maybe, what's that, about a second from the car ahead, which just went past us. And you can see the weather here becoming ever foggier. It was forecast to rain. It's just we just didn't know exactly at what point. So still dry. It's just very, very misty. And that is something very true of this circuit. My dad and I were here racing, I think it was a couple of years ago, and it just went from full sun to full rain in about 5 minutes. So the car that went past us over goes into the pit lane there. So you have to do a mandatory pit stop. So that they can lube the chain. So you can choose any time to do that, pretty much, I think, within 15 to 45 minutes. So you can't do it in the first 15 or last 15 minutes of the race, but in the middle half an hour you can do it. So the car ahead has gone in. I'm up into fourth at this point, so I think two people who were ahead have gone in. I haven't overtaken anyone, per se, not on track anyway. But I decided... it was best just to try to match the car ahead and just come in and not wait too long to do my pit stop. So we're going to come in, pull in and get some fresh chain lube, as we do right here. I was a little bit slow reacting to him telling me to go, but I didn't know the procedure. That's my excuse. And then there is the car there that was ahead of us, and he gets back past us. And to be fair, the gap's probably about the same as it was. Maybe I've gained a tiny amount, but not much different. So down in 12th, of course, courtesy of having done our pit stop, and some others ahead haven't done theirs yet. All we can do really is to try to push forward as much as we can. I see the gap behind, maybe about 2 seconds to the car behind at this point, as we are on lap number 31, not quite even halfway into the race. And it is a long race. An hour in a car, it's not exactly a sprint at all. And it is quite a test for a single lone driver. Go back past that guy who was behind us, and we gain a position. So he's actually probably a little bit closer than I'd like, within maybe about a second at that point there. So we're on, he's on it. He's out lap. I'm pushing. You can see that human DRS once again. And all we can do really is just try to push onto the back of that car ahead. And I think at this point, it really is a race for fifth. Well, what would be fifth once everyone's pitted. By lap 40, you can see I'm just beginning to gain slowly. Took a couple of laps to really get the best out of this car and really start gaining back on this guy. But I'm slowly beginning to do it here as we approach the halfway mark into the race. Into the final corner. Very, very fast, committed corner. Use the exit as much as possible. You can't go four wheels onto that curb, basically. But you can go two wheels onto it. Lap 42 now. Again, a little bit closer, or about the same. But let's see what we can do into the hairpin. Slightly later on the brakes, I'd say. Committing earlier. And overall, I'd say I gained through the hairpin. into the horseshoe. Not the easiest corner again, probably gaining through there as we come into this fast kink, easily flat out. It's not really even a corner. In the rain, it becomes a corner. And the rain is something that we do have to watch out for because it is getting ever murkier. Okay, we're fully in the slipstream. You see there just how much speed you gain in the slipstream. There's like a couple of miles an hour difference, and I went to the back of him. Just felt like we could work together. The thing I was worried about was getting into an unnecessary battle where we keep overtaking each other, because the cart behind isn't too far behind. So the more we keep fighting, the more the cart behind is just going to see that and get hope and begin to catch up, which is not something you want to do. You don't want to give the guy behind any mental chances, any reason to be positive about gaining on you. So we're going to work together at least for a little bit here. And again, look at the slipstream here, tucking in. And the carts are meant to be equal. That just shows you how much speed you gain. A couple of cart lengths gained every lap. And it's just a shame that at the start I couldn't quite get into the groove, get into the toe of the carts ahead. As are we gonna look for a move here into the hairpin? Have half a look. And I'll say he's quite slow through this hairpin. I was alright through there. So we're gonna get a good run out and go up the inside into the horseshoe. And we move up into our customary sixth position. So let's hope that we can work together here and perhaps try to pull away from the guy who is now in eighth, who was quite close. We're coming down in towards Billy's blind, the big braking zone at the bottom of the hill. He's going to go straight back past, and this is my fear. This is something I just don't really want to be involved with. It's just a constant ding-dong battle, which is pointless because we're only halfway into the race. So, okay, I'll settle in behind for now and perhaps bump draft him. It's just quite frustrating when you are a little bit quicker at this point of the race and you could work together, but they just decide not to. But there you go. What lap are we on now? 51. Lap 51. So you can see here, just sat behind him for a good 6-7 laps and just went for an absolutely savage move into the hairpin. Late on the brakes, point forward, and you see the guy in the yellow helmet is the guy I was worried about. He was the guy who was quite close, and you see he's actually a lot closer now because he went for a move as well, following me, or at least trying to follow me through. So that was actually a really satisfyingly pleasing move. Quite enjoyed that one. Having a quick look behind, see the tape trying to hold this camera on. This was before they got the new mounts on the carts. So through the chicane, should be flat out through here if you get it right. You see the camera picking up a lot of moisture, so it is kind of wet in the air at least, but the track is still dry. A bit of a mistake through the chicane on lap 55, and we're going to take a look behind. We're going to get overtaken once again by the number 13, so back down into 6th place, yellow helmet just behind as well. So this race could go one or two ways. Could get 5th, could get 6th, could get 7th. That's 3 ways. Could be even more, so it's not 2 ways at all, it could go many ways. Through the final corner, once again tucked into the slipstream. It's getting even darker now, even foggier. Coming down towards turn 1 on the brakes, we settle in nicely. Through the chicane, lap number 56 now, and we are beginning to enter the latter stage of the race. I'm pretty sure everyone would have done their pit stops by now, by this point. So it's really a case of, I think now you can really begin to start fighting. Even still, we're still maybe 15, 20 minutes away from the end of the race. So it's not, you know, you don't still want to fight too much at this point. I say last 10, last 5, that's where you really want to fight. And this is where my camera gave up the fight and decided to say goodbye. So once again, the Insta360 proving that it doesn't really want to stay on the cart, which isn't particularly useful for an onboard camera. But there you go. So we sat in this little piece of grass here by the side of the track. We can have a look around, courtesy of being a 360. But yeah, my race died there in the grass. Hello viewers. All right, we're gonna have to pick this one up in my car because obviously the camera fell off. Probably wondering what happened. Did I get sent to the Shadow Realm? Did I finish 6th? No, I finished 5th. I actually finished. Camera fell off. Let me show you what happened. Yeah, so this is the mount, and
Yep, thing just snapped. Clean off. And I think it's time to get a GoPro. As good as this Insta360 thing is, we retrieved the camera. Still works. I mean, still works, still fine. But yeah, this stupid thing doesn't work. My performance wasn't that good. I was making mistakes. I felt a bit tired at the end. Can't be perfect. You can't win them all, you know? And a note on Jimmy, he was actually really quick. He did actually really well. In the last sort of 20 minutes, I wasn't catching up with him. I could see him a bit further around the track, but I wasn't really catching him. He just made a mistake at the start, and he lost loads of time. That's why there was a massive gap at the start. I think he spun on the chicane first lap and just went straight to the back. So Shadow Realm Racing, Endurance 60 debut. Bit mixed, but good to be out there on the track once again. It looks like, well, let me show you. We've just missed the worst of the rain. Yeah. I was hoping that would come down at some point during the race and maybe save me, because I thought I'd be better in the rain than I would be in the dry, but didn't happen. It was like a Forza 7 race where it just gets a bit foggy and then it stops. So it was a bit annoying, but there you go. But that is all for me. Thank you so much for watching as always. Do appreciate the view. Thank you for making it this far into the video. Do drop a like and subscription and all that good malarkey. See you next time, everyone. Take care. Bye-bye.